Hey YouTube, this is Primetime Pokemon. In this video, I'll be reviewing and then giving away the Laser Focus theme deck. This is one of two theme decks from the Unified Minds expansion. This theme deck features Necrozma and is a psychic type deck. The other theme deck from Unified Minds is based around Dragonite. So the remainder of this video, I'll be reviewing each and every card in this deck, as well as providing the deck checklist and general strategy. And then at the end of the video, I'll be stating the rules to entry for the giveaway. And if you are looking for other theme deck reviews out there, I have reviewed every single theme deck released for the main expansions in the past several years. Theme decks are normally $12.99 in stores. As you can see on the back of the box, inside a theme deck, you get a 60 Pokemon card deck, a card checklist, metallic coin, two-player playmat and rule sheet, a code card for the TCG online, a quick guide to unlock the strategies within the theme deck, and damage counters. On the back of the box, the general strategy for the deck says the following: keep that laser firing. Help Necrozma get that laser dialed in perfectly. This deck recycles energy with Malamar's Psychic Recharge, so you always have enough power to push the attack. Audino and Silvally provide support as you zero in on the competition with the Laser Focus theme deck. Up on the screen now is the deck list for this theme deck. 24 total Pokemon, 16 trainer cards, and 20 total energy. Normally, in more competitive decks, you do want less Pokemon and many more trainer cards, but as a rule of thumb, theme decks are normally 20-20-20 when it comes to the three different types of cards. Malamar is one of the best energy acceleration engines in today's standard format. So the general strategy with this deck is pretty straightforward. Necrozma is going to be the primary attacker, doing up to 160 damage per turn. You want to get both Malamar set up on your bench so you can accelerate energy into play. Silvally would be a great attacker if your opponent knocks out one of your Pokemon. Ideally, that would be an even better attacker if your opponent knocks out one of your tag team GX, and that wouldn't happen in this theme deck. But in a modified theme deck, that would be the time to use it. It would do 180 damage in one turn. Inside the actual theme deck box, here are the physical items. The online TCG code card, which unlocks the deck, as well as the holo foil Necrozma, which is seen here. This is normally a rare non-holo from the Unified Minds expansion. That is also a pre-release promo for the set. The Pokemon coin included. Two-player playmat and rule sheet, quick guide for this theme deck, card checklist, damage counters, burn and poison marker, and GX marker, and then the deck box, which can hold 60 cards, the 60 cards required for this deck. On to the Pokemon first. Like I mentioned, 24 total Pokemon, two copies of this Necrozma. This is the featured Pokemon in the theme deck. It has a very good HP of 130, two attacks, barrier attack and special laser. Barrier attack for two energy cards does 30 damage, and then it says during your opponent's next turn, this Pokemon takes 30 less damage from attacks. Special laser is the move to use for three energy cards. It does 100 damage plus 60 more damage if this Pokemon has any special energy attached to it. And there are two copies of weakness guard energy that can be used with Necrozma. So 160 damage should knock out almost everything in theme decks out there. Next up would be a 2-2 line of Inkay and Malamar. Both of these cards are from Forbidden Light. Inkay, an HP of 60, only one move, a retreat cost of one colorless energy. Hypnosis puts the defending Pokemon to sleep. And then Malamar, a great ability on this card, a solid HP of 90. Psychic Recharge says, once during your turn, you may attach a psychic energy from your discard pile to one of your bench Pokemon. So the strategy here is to have Necrozma on the bench, use Psychic Recharge twice, put two energy cards on Necrozma, attach a psychic energy from hand, and then you have Necrozma set up as early as turn two, and then it can do 160 damage. The thing you have to think about with this deck is to be able to retreat your active Pokemon to move in something like Necrozma, Tate, and Liza would be one way to do this. Psychic Sphere on that card can do 60 damage, which isn't much for 3 energy cards. Mesprit is next. 2 copies of this card. This is from Unified Minds, 60 for the HP, 2 moves. First Contact and Mumble. First Contact says, search your deck for up to 3 basic Pokemon and put them on your bench, then shuffle your deck. So if you're able to get this into the active Pokemon spot to start the game, you could search for 2 Inkay and a Necrozma, and then Mumble for 1 Psychic Energy does 20 damage. That would be it for the Psychic type Pokemon in the deck. 1 Fairy type in Dedenne. And there are 2 copies of this card, 70 for the HP, return for 1 colorless energy, does 20 damage, plus you may draw cards until you have 6 cards in your hand. So this is another good Pokemon to start in the active Pokemon spot at the beginning of the game. A low retreat cost here as well, so it is an easy retreat to get Necrozma into that active Pokemon spot. A 3-2 line of Yungoos and Gumshoos would be next. 70 for the HP, so a little bit above average. It only does have 1 move, Cavernous Chomp, which requires 2 energy cards and does 30 damage. And then Gumshoos, an HP of 100, 1 attack, Alert Headbutt, which does 90 damage for 2 energy cards. If your opponent's active Pokemon is a Pokemon GX or EX, this attack's base damage is 30. Which isn't very good, so it's actually better to use in a theme deck. So a somewhat powerful attacker there. A 3-2 line of type Null and Silvally would be next. A very good HP for a basic of 100 on this card. 2 attacks, Smash Kick and Quick Blow. Smash Kick does 20 damage for 1 energy card, and Quick Blow does 30 damage for 2 energy cards. Plus, flip a coin if has this attack does 30 more damage. So this is also a decent starter Pokemon for a battle. I'd rather set up some of my Pokemon and use something like Dedenne to get more cards into my hand, or Mesprit to get those basic Pokemon onto the bench. So Silvally would be next, a good HP of 130, 2 attacks, Avenging Heart and Air Slash. Avenging Heart requires 2 energy cards and does 30 damage, plus 50 more damage for each prize card your opponent took on their last turn. Like I mentioned in the open, this card could easily do 180 damage. And then Air Slash for 3 energy cards does 120 damage. It is disappointing that you have to discard an energy from this Pokemon, but you can then recycle it back onto your bench with Malamar. So not too bad of an attacker there. 2 copies of Audino are also in the deck, 90 for the HP on this basic evolution form. Hearing is this card's ability once during your turn. If this Pokemon is your active Pokemon, you may draw a card. So it definitely helps early on getting more cards into your hand. I do like that it has a low retreat cost. And then Drain Slap for 2 energy cards does 30 damage, plus you can heal 30 damage from this Pokemon. So if you are able to get 2 energy cards on Audino, early in the game you may just want to use Hearing and then continuously do 30 damage to the offending Pokemon plus heal damage from Audino. The final Pokemon in this theme deck would be Tauros, 2 copies of this card. All the cards in this theme deck for Pokemon outside of Inkay and Malamar are from Unified Minds. 110 for the HP, a low retreat cost as well, 2 attacks. Call for Family and Berserker Tackle. Call for Family allows you to search your deck for a basic Pokemon and put it on your bench. And then Berserker Tackle does 60 damage for 2 energy cards. Unfortunately, Tauros does 10 damage to itself. So overall, when it comes to the Pokemon, I do like the combination of Malamar and Necrozma. Like I mentioned, in the competitive scene, Malamar is a great deck archetype for accelerating energy into play. You can actually use that with Ultra Necrozma GX or even something like Garchomp and Giratina GX. I wish the other cards in this deck were a little bit stronger, but I do like Dedenne as well as Mesprit for helping out early in the game. Same goes for Audino. So about average when it comes to the Pokemon in this theme deck. It is almost worth it to buy this theme deck just to get a couple of copies of Malamar as well as some of the trainer cards that I'll mention now. 16 total trainer cards in this theme deck. 11 would be supporters. Supporter cards, you can only use one per turn. First up would be Bug Catcher, two copies of this card. Every single trainer, when it comes to the supporter cards, two copies of, except for Tate and Liza, only one. So this trainer says, draw two cards, flip a coin. If heads, draw two more cards. There are much better supporter cards out there than this one. Cynthia would be a card you'd want to include four of in a theme deck or any deck out there. Shuffle your hand into your deck, then draw six cards. How allows you to draw three cards. Lillie is a great supporter to use the first turn. Draw cards until you have six cards in your hand. If it's your first turn, draw cards until you have eight cards in your hand. Pokemon Fan Club, search your deck for up to two basic Pokemon, reveal them, and put them into your hand. Then shuffle your deck. What I like about this card is some Pokemon out there have abilities that will fire when you move them from your hand to the bench. Some trainer cards out there make you put Pokemon right on the bench and therefore making it so that abilities will not work. And then the final supporter, just the one copy of Tate and Liza, two options on this one. Shuffle your hand into your deck, then draw five cards, or switch your active Pokemon with one of your bench Pokemon. Like I mentioned, you want to put Necrozma on the bench in the beginning of the game, accelerate energy to it with Malamar, and then use Tate and Liza to get that Necrozma into the active Pokemon spot. So there are some very good supporter cards in this theme deck, Cynthia and Lillie being the two best ones. When it comes to the item cards, five total. Two copies of this mysterious treasure. Discard a card from your hand. If you do, search your deck for a psychic or dragon type Pokemon. Reveal it and put it into your hand. Then shuffle your deck. Great to use with both Malamar and Inkay. U-turn board, two copies of this tool. The retreat cost of the Pokemon this card is attached to is one colorless energy less. So a great way to retreat for free. Lots of Pokemon in this deck only have a one colorless energy retreat cost. And then the final item card, another way to retreat for free, one copy of Switch. Switch your active Pokemon with one of your bench Pokemon. So I do like the item cards quite well. And overall, I am a big fan of the trainer cards in this theme deck outside of Bug Catcher. Lastly would be the energy cards. 20 total, 18 psychic energy, and then two of the weakness guard energy, a special energy. This card provides one colorless energy. The Pokemon this card is attached to has no weakness. But the main reason you want to use a special energy is to make it so Necrozma can do more damage when attacking. So there is a look at all of the cards in the laser focus theme deck from the Unified Minds expansion. Overall, I think this is an average theme deck. Most theme decks released are average when it comes to a rating. If you are looking for one of the better ones out there, both from the Ultra Prism expansion are quite good and they are above average. But again, this deck is very good when it comes to having two copies of Malamar and then two copies of both Lillie and Cynthia. When it comes to the rules to entry for this giveaway, it is quite simple. All you have to do is you have to subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video, and then in the comment section of this video, just state that you'd like to enter the giveaway. At the end of August, August 31st, I will be using a random number generator to randomly select an entrant into this giveaway, and I will be contacting them saying that they've won via email. So make sure the About section of your channel has been updated so that I can contact you. Good luck to everyone who does enter. This giveaway is open to everyone worldwide, and I will be reviewing the other theme deck from Unified Minds in the next week or two. So, good luck again to everyone who does enter. Thanks everyone for watching. As always, before you go, make sure to check out all the links in the description of this video, including links to my blog, Facebook, and Twitter pages. So thanks everyone for watching, and stay tuned for more videos. Thank you.